exclusive. Maltese government approves three cryptocurrency bills. The Maltese parliament yesterday voted unanimously to approve three cryptocurrency and blockchain bills. Those bills that are designed to make Malta one of the most important and desirable locations in the blockchain space should now facilitate the setting up of further companies in this sector. On Twitter shortly after the vote, Parliamentary Secretary for Digital Innovation, Silvio Scamberi, said he was honored to have as spearhead the legalization through Parliament and also expressed thanks to all those who had collaborated on this project. He also announced that Mr. Stephen McCarthy will be the new CEO of Malta Digital Innovation Authority. Junior Minister delegate to speak ahead the process. Junior Minister also expressed optimism on the way that those new bills will allow the crypto and blockchain sector to flourish. Dr. Joseph F. Borg, a partner at WH Advocates, and Solicitors and founder of Bit Malta on those important developments. Today is a historic day for blockchain cryptocurrency enthusiasts, professionals and entrepreneurs in Malta. It is the first step to make Malta the jurisdiction of choice for blockchain businesses. The fact the parliament unanimously voted in favor of those three bills is crucial for the stability of the sector and for Malta to become the hub of blockchain and cryptocurrency businesses. Well done to all involved. The Malta Digital Innovation Authority Bill is the first bill which gives wide scope to the regulation of cryptocurrency and the blockchain space. The bill establishes the Malta Digital Innovation Authority and will focus on internal governance arrangements. The affairs and business of the authority will be carried out by a board of governors. The bill will also outline the duties and responsibilities of the authority, one of the key roles being to certificate of DLT platforms to ensure credibility and provide legal certainty to users wishing to make use of a DLT platform. The purpose of the surveyors and the certification of DLT platform is to appraise the functioning of DLT platform and ensure that the data being lodged is accurate and genuine information. The consultation document issued on the 17th February 2018 proposed that the certification of DLT platform will not be a mandatory requirement but will be made voluntary.